morning, YouTube. I'm still in Piqua, Ohio. I'm on the northern edge of the city. This is Forest Hill Union Cemetery. It's Ohio historical marker here. You can see a little bit of information about the cemetery right here. So I'm gonna make some videos of this. I really don't know how many I'm gonna make of this cemetery. Looks pretty nice. It's on the northern edge of Piqua. Wright Brothers Maple, of course, those that are familiar with the Dayton region are familiar with the Wright Brothers. Here you can see some really old graves right here, 1877 right here. This might be some fresh dirt right here, but I don't know how old the grave is, but so this looks pretty nice right here. Beautiful cemetery. Here you got some really old grave sites right here. 1891. You see they're all family Schroff. I'm not sure if I pronounced that right. Schroff family right through here. But So I'm enjoying the day. It's a beautiful morning. I've already got a decent amount of footage and it's not even 10 a.m. yet through here. See, these are some older grave sites from the Hall family right here. So this is probably one of the older sections of the cemetery. It said something about 1868 on the historical marker. There's 1911, Henry C. Worley. Now this is a really old grave site too, 1870, 1855. So man, this might be older than the historical marker even indicated. It really is a beautiful day outside today. So I'm gonna make some videos of this. I don't know how many I'm gonna make, but I believe this is some veterans cemeteries. Yeah, private right here. Lewis Alsmeyer right here. So it looks like these are some guys who were probably in World War II. Some of them might have died deserted and some of them afterwards. In memory of our comrades right here. That thing that dots this part of the cemetery. There's quite a bit here to cover, so I probably am not going to cover all of this, but I'll get some good bits of it here and there. This says May's Lot right here. It's only a short one, but I guess this is for the May family. Oh, here's an interesting one. I think this might be some beavers or something on this gravestone. So they have their own plot in this little section of the cemetery. They've been gone for a while. I'm not sure how many of their remnants of their family are still Polk, so that's different section. So I'm not exactly sure how many. Got a few joggers jogging through the cemetery right now. I'm not gonna really get up close to all these because it would just be way too much to cover, even though I got plenty of battery footage, but I got a couple other things I want to cover while I'm up this way too. There's a historical society that I'm gonna ride up to, and then there's Lockington Dam, which is about 4 miles or so from here. Just have to see where good starting and good ending points are for this video. I'm not really that familiar with the cemetery because, as you guys know, I live down in Dayton, more East Dayton, but I do enjoy coming up here showing you guys other parts of the Miami Valley. And I've always liked, you know, coming up to Piqua, although I don't come up here as much as I used to when I was younger, of course, but some nice shaded spots for some trees right through here. Butcher family. Yeah, they've been gone for a while. Tobias family. There's an old grave too. It's been pretty well maintained too. Another entrance to the cemetery up that road. I came in the front way off of 66. Here there's a mausoleum right up here. That'll probably be a good ending point for this first video. Then I'll walk around and cover some more of this. Brooks family right there, father and mother. There's an old grave site right there. But I'm gonna get ready to end this one, and I got room for one more shorter video on this card. Then I'm gonna switch out my batteries on this. Yeah, this is section 4 right through here. General William Poor. So this will be a good point to end this right at this mausoleum. So that's it for this one.